بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. So we said a quick summary of what we said last time. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was trying to spread Islam early on in secret for the first 3 years. But that was not 100% secret. Of course, Quraysh heard about it. They heard some rumors. They didn't take it as a big deal. They thought it was just a phase because some people did the same thing before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They claimed to be prophets and all that. And then after that, they maybe grew out of it or something like this. So they didn't think it's going to be a big deal until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَأَنذِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, give warning to your close family members. And we said this last time, your priority should be your family members. And we said he invited his uncles, his cousins, even his daughter was there, Fatima radiallahu anha, she was only 5. He tried to give them the da'wah to invite them to Islam first time. Abu Lahab, his uncle, did not let him speak. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam waited, and then he invited them again, and he called them to Islam. And we said there was a big confrontation in that meeting between Abu Talib, the Prophet's uncle, and Abu Lahab, the Prophet's uncle. Both of them were the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's uncles. And Abu Talib said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do what you think is right, and I am with you, I will protect you. Abu Lahab said the opposite, the exact opposite. He said, we will stop you no matter what, you're going to bring us shame. That was the two, you want to say, poles in the family. And Abu Talib said the last thing we said last time, Abu Talib said to Abu Lahab, he said, as long as I am alive, nobody will touch him with any harm. And of course, those were beautiful words coming from the mouth of the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Unfortunately, we know that Abu Talib did not become a Muslim and he died as a mushrik. There is a small, of course, opinion of some scholars say Abu Talib will not stay in hellfire forever. And he will come out of hellfire eventually and he will be given Jannah. So that is possible and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.
It is saying that Abu Talib only legs were...
Only his feet. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that because of my dua, Abu Talib, my uncle, will be standing on 2 burning rocks in hellfire. Because of them, his brain will boil. So only his feet are in hellfire and his brain will boil because of that. All of his life, Abu Talib, 2 things he never abandoned. His nephew, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was by his side, but at the same time, he didn't want to lose his position in Quraysh. So since he was one of the chiefs, he wanted to keep that position and that prevented him from accepting Islam. Now, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the meeting with his family, another command came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the command was, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَأَعْرَضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. It is time to announce Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he knew what's going to happen. Of course, a lot of opposition, a lot of hatred, and the Prophet's life completely changed after he announced Islam. Completely, like, what do you want to say, 180 degrees. He climbed on the mountain of Safa, and he gathered the whole Quraysh. Yeah. And he said, what is your opinion in me? Walaikum salam, Shaykh Ahmed. So he said to them, what is your opinion in me? Have I ever lied to you? They said, you have not lied to us ever. So that was their own testimony, the people of Quraysh. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then what do you say if I was to tell you that there is a big army behind that hill? There was a small hill behind them that is about to attack you. They looked and there was nothing there. They said, we still believe you. Even though we cannot see anything, we still believe you because you never lied. You're not going to start lying now. He said, then I am a warner to you that there will be a great punishment. Now, Abu Lahab, the Prophet's uncle, was standing there. He said, curse be to you. Is that why you gathered us here? The first one who spoke and started cursing at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was his own uncle. And that again explains why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives Abu Lahab a whole surah just for himself to say, curse be to Abu Lahab and his hands and his wife. And as we explained that
on Friday. So the first one to show opposition to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was his own uncle, Abu Lahab. And since that day, things completely changed. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the target of the young and the old, men and women, all kind of abuse you can imagine, physical abuse, making fun of him and his message, doing all kind of things that you can imagine. Everything changed when Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam announced Islam. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, of course, tried his best to talk to his family members, as we mentioned. Unfortunately, Abu Talib did not accept Islam, although he was his first supporter. And Abu Lahab did not accept Islam, but Abu Lahab was on the extreme end. He tried everything to stop the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. At that point, Quraysh kind of like had this emergency meeting, urgent meeting, to discuss what to do about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They said the best way to stop him is to approach his uncle, Abu Talib, because Abu Talib is his supporter and protector. Abu Talib, as we mentioned, did not say that he's a Muslim, but at the same time, he would not let anybody hurt the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he did get in a lot of conflicts with Quraysh because of that. So they said, how about we go to Abu Talib, we talk to him nicely, gently, and we tell him, please keep your nephew away from us. Don't let him talk to people about Islam, especially that the Hajj season was about to start. And the Quraysh were so scared that when the, of course, the Hajj season, people come from all over the place. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was actually waiting for the Hajj season to talk to people about Islam. And all the tribes that come from different areas of Arabia were going to come to Mecca during the season of Hajj. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was waiting for that opportunity, and Quraysh were afraid. So they said, first, let's go talk to Abu Talib. They went to Abu Talib, his uncle, and they told him, they talked to him nicely, gently, please, we don't want anything from you, just tell Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Muhammad, to stop doing this prophethood thing and talking to people about Islam. Remember, Islam makes fun of their own religion, the worshipping idols and worshipping stone, which is something that does not make sense logically. How can you, at the end of the day, bow down to a stone or dates or and they used to give them qurbani and sacrifice, by the way. They used to cut the biha for their idols. And they will put the meat by the idol. And normally the one who cleans the idol steals the meat at the end of the day. That's normally how it works. So, and they used to think that the idol ate it or something. It's terrible. Yeah. So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever Allah does not guide, nobody can guide them. A person can be so, subhanAllah, stupid. How can you do something like that? Anyhow, so Abu Talib told them, okay, I will talk to him. And he called the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he said, my dear nephew, again, Abu Talib really loved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He told him that Quraysh came to me. Of course, when I say Quraysh, that does not mean the whole tribe, the chiefs, the big people, the nobles. Quraysh approached me and they asked me to tell you to stop. And they have come more than one time. And every time they come, I tell them, okay, I'll talk to him. And he never talks to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Basically, he's just delaying it. But then when they pushed him too much, Abu Talib called the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and said, can you please stop? Because I cannot tell Quraysh to come back again later because, you know, it's been already too many times. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said his famous hadith, low authenticity, but it's a beautiful hadith. He said, Wallahi ya am, by Allah, O my uncle, if they were to put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left hand, I will not abandon this matter, meaning Islam, until I either get victory from Allah or I die trying. So I either be victorious or I will die trying. When Abu Talib saw the determination in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, by Allah, I will not let them touch you. Do whatever you want. So that's why it's sad that Abu Talib died as a mushrik. After doing all this, and he went through a lot protecting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, when Quraysh realized that Abu Talib cannot help them, they gathered again. They had another meeting again. Looks like they like each other. They have meetings every day. So in the meeting, they said, the Hajj is coming, and we need to find or make a plan so we don't let Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam convert the tribes that are coming. What do we do? Remember, the Hajj was their season to make a lot of money, tourism. And they all come to worship their idols. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam convinces them there is no idols, Quraysh will lose a lot of... And it's mentioned in the Quran, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about that. So they went to their elder, his name was Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah, the father of Khalid ibn al-Walid. And they sat with him and they told him, give us your advice. Hajj is approaching and we have no plan. What are we going to do about this problem, the Islam? He told them, you, all of you, accuse Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in different things. Some of you say he's a sahir, magician. Some of you say he's a sha'ir, poet. Some of you say he's majnun, crazy. If every one of us will say something different, the tribes will not listen to us, right? Makes sense. We all have to unite on one thing. Decide one thing, and we'll go with that. So if that makes sense, if the whole Quraysh say about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one thing, then people will believe. But everybody says something different, nobody will believe. Somebody say he's crazy, so no, he's not crazy, he's a poet. No, he's not a poet, he's a sahir, he's a magician. So we have to agree on one thing. So they actually said that you're making a lot of sense. How about you tell us? What should we say? So Walid ibn Mughirah said, let me go talk to him. And he goes to talk to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, oh Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he was again very polite. He said, tell us what you want. What is that thing that you want? And we'll give it to you. You want money? We'll gather money from all the tribe leaders. We'll make you the most wealthiest amongst us. You want women? Tell us which one you want. We'll let you have her. You marry her. You want fame? We'll make you the most famous. You want to become our leader? We'll appoint you our leader, as long as you leave Islam alone. Now look at the Prophet ﷺ and how polite he was. When Al-Walid stopped talking, he said, "Afaragta ya am? Are you done, my uncle?" So he called him my uncle again. And these were the manners of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. If it was us, hey, old man, go away. Stop bothering me, right? So the Prophet ﷺ was very polite. So Al-Walid Mughirah was polite, but the Prophet ﷺ was even more polite. He said, are you done? He didn't want to interrupt him. You're done talking? He said, yes. And then he started reciting the Quran, Surah Fussilat. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل من الرحمن الرحيم. Beautiful surah. And Al-Walid ibn Mughirah is listening until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got to the ayah that says, فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُوا فَقُلْ أَنذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْلَ صَاعِقَةِ عَادٍ وَثَمُودٍ. If those people, talking about Quraysh, reject you, then tell them, I am warning you that the destruction will come to you the same way it came to Ad and Thamud. Al-Walid ibn Mughirah put his hand on the Prophet's mouth. He said, by Allah, stop talking. He got scared. He got really scared, terrified. But why would he get terrified? He did not believe. If he believed the Quran were the words of Allah, why is he not a Muslim? See, this is the thing. They knew he was not lying. But they didn't want to lose their position. They didn't want to lose their money. That's the main thing. Today, the same thing with Muslims. I will say the word of batil, and I will be on the side of the falsehood because I don't want to lose my money. I don't want to lose my position. If I'm going to get in trouble, if I stand with the haqq, I don't want to stand with the haqq. And that's the problem even with Muslims today. So Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah goes back to Quraysh. And of course, the nobles of Quraysh were waiting for him, right? They sent him to talk to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they are still discussing what to do for the Hajj season that is coming. That's the main thing. So when Abu Jahl saw Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah coming from far, he said, by Allah, this is not the same face he left us with. His face changed when he heard the Quran. The Quran is very powerful. When you understand the Quran, it goes right from the ear to the heart. You cannot stop it. And that's why we always talk about understanding the Quran. Important, the importance of understanding the Quran. Muslims today are so behind because we do not understand the Quran. Imagine a mushrik, Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah, who dies as a mushrik. When he heard the words of the Quran, his face color changed. He became pale. He got scared. It's powerful. The Quran is very powerful. So imagine if a Muslim listens to the Quran, nothing changes in us because we don't understand. So Abu Jahl said to the nobles of Quraysh, that face is not the same face he left us with. So when he came back, they told him, what do you think we should do? Remember, his idea was, we're going to all unite in the Hajj season to call him one thing. We're not going to call him different things. So they saw he was actually Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah got to the point of almost accepting Islam. He said, wallahi, I have heard poetry, and that is not poetry.
Very beautiful Quran wording at this point.
Yeah, the Quran is powerful. The Quran is very beautiful. We are missing out. He said, I have heard poetry. And for them, remember, poetry was their thing. They hear poetry day and night. That was their TV, poetry. So Abu Walid al-Mughirah said, I heard poetry. And by Allah, this is not poetry. And I have heard the magicians. I have seen witchcraft. Wa alaykum salam. And by Allah, this is not sihr. This is not witchcraft. And I have seen crazy people. Well, they called him Majnoon, right? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they called him crazy, insane. And by Allah, he is not crazy. And the Quraysh were getting worried because imagine if Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah, that big noble and the elder, becomes a Muslim, the whole Mecca will become Muslim. So they said, I don't like where that is going. They said, you have to pick something and we'll go with it. So Walid ibn al-Mughirah said, let me go home and I will tell you what to decide. Subhanallah, he was alone at home. There was nobody there. And he was going in circles, thinking about the words of the Quran. And that's what Allah mentions in the Quran. إِنَّهُ فَكَّرَ وَقَدَّرْ فَقُتِلَ كَيْفَ قَدَّرْ ثُمَّ قُتِلَ كَيْفَ قَدَّرْ ثُمَّ نَظَرْ ثُمَّ عَبَسَ وَبَسَرْ. Allah explains exactly the situation of Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah, although he was home alone. Nobody was there to tell the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who claim that Prophet Muhammad made the Quran sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how did he know that what Walid ibn al-Mughirah was going through? Allah talks about what Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah was thinking even. That he thought.
Word by word.
And he understood the Quran. And he loved the Quran. He said here, إِنَّ لِكَلَامِهِ لَطَلَاوَ. It's like his words are like sweet. You know, when you eat sweets, the Quran is so beautiful. And that's why Abu Jahl, when he heard the words from Walid ibn al-Mughirah, his closer friend, he said, if you say one more word praising that book, the Quran, or the Quran, the recitation of the Prophet, I will never talk to you again. Al-Walid al-Mughirah chose Abu Jahl over the Quran. That's why we always say, make sure you have good friends. Your friends influence you a lot.
He chose
hellfire. Allahumma rabba hadhihi ta'ala ta'ala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is exactly what he said. It's mentioned in the Quran. Wallahi inna li qawlihi la halawa. Al-Walid ibn al-Mughirah is saying about the Quran. His statement is very beautiful, very sweet. Wa inna aslahu la adaq. وَإِنَّ فُرْعَهُ لَجَنَا. It's like a tree. He's describing the Quran like a beautiful tree. The beginning is a beautiful trunk, and then the branches are even more beautiful. He's saying the Quran is something that's unbelievable, basically. He's praising the Quran. And then he said, whatever you choose to talk about him is certainly a lie. If you tell the people who are coming for Hajj, he's a sahir, they will figure it out he's not a sahir when they hear the Quran. And if you tell them he's a sha'ir, they will figure it out he's not a sha'ir when they hear the Quran. I heard it. He's telling them, I heard it. It's not like that. So at this point, Abu Jahl interfered. He said, you have to tell us one thing. You choose. You have to choose sahir, sha'ir, majnoon. You cannot do that. And this is when he goes home, he goes in circles, and then comes back. And this is when Allah says, إِنَّهُ فَكَّرَ وَقَدَّرَ فَقُتِلَ كَيْفَ قَدَّرَ. Curse be to him, because he was so close. He saw the beauty of the Quran. Allah is cursing at him in Surah Al-Muddathir. ثُمَّ نَظَرَ, and then he looked, ثُمَّ عَبَسَ وَبَسَرَ, and then he became upset. Al-Walid ibn Mughirah became angry with himself. Because you know when the haqq is very clear and you still don't want to do it. ثُمَّ نَظَرَ ثُمَّ عَبَسَ وَبَسَرَ ثُمَّ أَدْبَرَ وَاسْتَكْبَرَ. And then he turned around and his arrogance prevailed. His arrogance was victorious. ثُمَّ أَدْبَرَ وَاسْتَكْبَرَ. And then he said, فَقَالَ إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ يُؤْثَرْ. Let's say this is magic. So he chose to call the Quran witchcraft. And this is mentioned in the Quran. And that's why Allah says, سَأُصْلِيهِ سَقَرْ. Since he got so close, Allah designed a whole place in hellfire for him called Saqar. Just for Al-Walid ibn Mughira. Because there is a difference between people who never seen the beauty of the Quran and somebody who got so close. He got upset with himself. Abasa wa basar. He became upset with himself. Why do you not believe? It's obvious. And he said here that the words of the Quran are so beautiful and sweet. So he chose to go with the mushrikeen. And that's why Allah mentions him in the Quran, سَأُصْلِيهِ سَقَرْ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سَقَرْ لَا تُبْقِي وَلَا تَذَرْ. سَقَرْ, whoever goes there, nothing will be left of him. لَوَّاحَةٌ لِلْبَشَرْ. So, that's a deep level in hellfire. They finally decided that they're going to call him a sahir. And not only that, subhanAllah, their level of hatred. They decided when the tribes are coming to stand for them outside of Mecca before the Prophet ﷺ gets to them and to tell them that there is a man inside, his name is Muhammad ﷺ, is going to tell you about Islam, don't listen to him. And Abu Lahab, look how terrible Abu Lahab was. He volunteered. He said, I will follow him wherever he goes. And when he starts talking to somebody, I will raise my voice and I will tell that somebody, stay away from him, he's crazy, or he's sahir, and I am his uncle. I know him better than anybody. Don't listen to him. Imagine if your uncle is telling the people to stay away from you. His family. His family. So, actually, there is a funny story that happened that's not mentioned in the book. This is an extracurricular activity. There was actually a doctor who treats magic and witchcraft, supposed to be a doctor, right? He was passing by Mecca. So Quraysh stopped him. They said, we are looking for somebody like you. We have a man, he has a problem of magic. Please come and cure him. So he said, okay, that's my specialty. I have PhD in witchcraft treatment, 25 years. Of course, I made that part of the 25 years. I don't know how many years. So he came, and then he goes to the house of the Prophet ﷺ. And again, we see the manners of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. He knocks at the door. The Prophet ﷺ opens the door. He doesn't know him. That's a stranger. He's not from Quraysh. So the man said, he was very clear. He said, your people are saying we have witchcraft problem, and I have come to help you. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? Of course, if it was you or I, they are the crazy ones. They're crazy. Let's go beat them up. Oh, so the Prophet ﷺ actually said, okay, let me tell you what I complain of. right? When you see the doctor, you tell him what you complain of. So I tell him, please come in. So the man came inside. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wanted to tell him what he's complained of, and but he's going to start with in alhamdulillah, the introduction. Nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu bihi wa nasta'inu. The same instruction. And it's a beautiful introduction. I praise Allah. I depend only on Allah. I ask him for guidance, and I know if he does not guide me, I will never be guided. Beautiful words. People normally fall asleep when the imam is saying the introduction. When the Prophet finished the introduction and he's about to start, the man told him, 1 second, can you say that again? So he said, okay, in alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu bihi wa nasta'dihi wa nastaghfiruh. Of course, the man can understand what the Prophet is saying, 100%. He said, say it a third time. And then the man said, I travel a lot. And I have heard so many people starting their speech with different things. I have not heard anything so beautiful in my life. And he became a Muslim. He came to treat the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from witchcraft. He became a Muslim. He was treated. Yeah. So, but again, this shows us that the how polite the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was. If the Prophet told them, they're crazy, they're the magicians. I have nothing to do. The man would have left and he would not have accepted Islam. The Prophet ﷺ said, yes, very well, please come in, let me tell you what I have, what the problem that I have. And the man accepted Islam. And again, we are, as Muslims, missing on the manners part today. We don't have the manners of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami'ul alim. Wa'fu anna innaka anta al-ghafurur rahim. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.